contest diet is 100 grams of oats, 6 egg whites, 250 grams of lean mince. That's meal one. Meal two is 200 grams of chicken, mixed veg, 125 grams of basmati rice. And that's meal two and three. Meal four, 10 egg omelet. Meal five is 200 grams of steak, mixed veg, two eggs. Meal six, 10 eggs, two yolks. That's pretty much it.
Every day.
Oh,
would that differ as the winter
time? Just take a basmati rice out, two and three. Just as a comment.
That's it.
Just keep it all the same. Yeah. Use a bit of oils, you know, pop some oil blend. Use sea salt to flavour, black pepper, cinnamon in the oats and egg whites.
So if you drop in £12 whatever, 3 months, clearly that went by the scales. You're not getting away every week and saying, I've only dropped a pound.
No. I think
it's only by the
scales can be, I mean, you can drop water, can't you, overnight? You lose loads, can't you? Scales can be a bit of a mind game. I understand if you're helping somebody prep, then you need to know what they weigh generally, just to get an idea. But you can battle yourself with scales. You see guys, I mean, it's typical, you know, guys start prepping at 20 stone. 20 stone, I've got my abs out. We've not even started. 3 weeks in, 18.5 stone, still got my abs. 7 weeks in, 15 stone, still got my abs. You know what I mean? So the body weight is just falling. Yeah, they think that all this water weight inside the muscle is on the outside, and it just drops out.
So, okay, going back to that, dieting nice and steady.
Yeah.
In a relatively short space of time, you should have much. Cardio-wise,
just do 45 minutes.
From week number one?
Day one of the diet. Cardio, a lot of it, I do for just the mental thing. When I wake up.
Because you're mental.
Yeah. My nutrition for 12 weeks, and then you get pulled on the pair of trunks on cut yourself in 8 times. You like spend all your money in a week on the bottom, so you have to, just do it in the morning, 45 minutes, and then in about week seven weeks out, I'll put in 30 minutes at night, and then about 5 weeks out, I'll put in 2 blocks of 45, 1 at minute and 1 at night. But then when you get body fat gets so low and your water weight drops out so much, cardio at night is probably unnecessary. Mm-hmm. I don't think you really, you can, I've seen guys walk their legs off.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They come on, but you think, fucking hell, haven't your legs just gone?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that can happen. That happens to me. The first place it goes is on the outer sweep. So if I've done like 2 shows in a row, and then I try to cardio for the third show, sometimes you can see it dropped off. I'm like, right. Yeah. And there's one thing on a bodybuilder that he always needs, I think, is big quads. Yeah.
So if you're ready, okay, you've done your first show, nailed it.
Yeah.
Another show 3 weeks later.
Yeah.
Do you cut cardio out, or do you do a little bit tonight, or what do you do?
I keep it in the morning, and then just keep an eye on myself in the mirror, and think if anything, you know. But I don't let it go too far out. I can rein it back in with food as well. Mm. You know what I mean? You can go, if you want to, a couple of days zero carb if you have to. Don't recommend it. It's keto diet. My family.
We were saying earlier about cheat meals. What should you take?
Cheat meals. If you're stage ready, if you're way ahead of yourself. But a cheat meal, generally stick to the foods that I'm eating anyway. Like say, you have a Nando's. I won't go like pizza and McDonald's and all that. You just make yourself ill. You know, I think it was, when I dated for the first time now, I went to an Italian, and I was out here, and I couldn't shoot it out the other end. It was horrible. That's what she gave me. She said, look at the salt, because, you know, when you get that low, your body gets that starved because you're not producing any, what's it called, digestive enzyme in your stomach. Dodgy boy. And you know when you're eating it with your arse raised.
Yeah.
But if you think about it, when you're dieting for sure, afterwards you can create like an eating disorder because you've been craving stuff for so long, and then you like gorge on it. It's just like swinging it. So, you know.
Is that what you'll go after? I suppose everybody does.
You generally, because you've been in the routine for so long, you stick to it for like 2 or 3 days and it just generally just drifts off. That's what you were saying, you know, when you went away, and then you've got to bring it all back in.
Yeah.
That's why I would always keep it, but we'd keep the routine of it. If I had another show like 2 or 3 weeks later, wouldn't break it.
Would you be carb
a little bit then? Exactly that. I'd keep all the food sources the same, but I'd just put the carb sources higher just to support it, and then I'd just drop it back down again.
Yeah.
And then generally, from the first show to the second show, my body gets better. You get a lot of a bit of a rebound here. You know, throw yourself back into the gym, throw your food back in and everything that you didn't like, your body sucked it all back in.
Yeah.
So.